Wales doesn't have a police force, so a call went out to the community for help when the bear was still outside. Someone who hadn't been named came with a gun and shot the bear, still attacking Myomick and her son. In today's video, we'll tell you how this polar bear fatally mauled the mother and son in Alaska. If you're the bold type, this is a challenge for you. Would you be able to stay till the end, or would you get scared off? Only one way to find out. Watch this video. Officials said that the two people killed by a polar bear in Alaska were a young mother and her one-year-old son. They also noted that the two were brutally attacked in front of a school where scared children were inside. Summer Myomick, who was 24 years old, was carrying her son Clyde Ongtowasruk while walking from Kingikmuit School in Wales to a health clinic just 150 yards away, around 2 p.m. A large bear broke through a cloud of swirling snow and attacked the pair. Their deaths were the first deaths caused by a polar bear attack in the U.S. in about 30 years. The tragedy devastated the 150 people who lived in a small whaling town in Alaska. Susan Needza, the chief administrator of the Bering Strait School District, said that the bloodshed could have been worse if the school administrators hadn't done what they did. Principal Don Hendrickson put the building, which is also a community center, on lockdown and closed all the blinds so the kids wouldn't see the horrifying attack. Several school workers and people from the neighborhood then ran out of the school with shovels to scare the polar bear away from Myomick and her baby. The bear stopped for a moment, but then turned around and ran at the people with shovels. They ran back inside, and Needza said that Hendrickson slammed the school door shut in front of the wild animal, potentially saving lives. The head of the Bering Strait School District, Susan Needza, said the polar bear was chasing them and tried to get in. "It's terrible, something you never thought you'd ever do," she added. Since there were no police in the small, remote village of about 150 people, a call for help went out to the people who lived there. The bear was still outside. The bodies of Ms. Myomick and her son were flown to Nomad. Will be taken to the state medical examiner's office in Anchorage. Samples of the bear were taken to the state veterinarian. Alaska state troopers said that the mother probably didn't know they were in immediate danger from a polar bear when they left school in a blinding snowstorm. A state trooper and a wildlife official flew to Wales, the western point of North America, the day after the attack. Myomick also had a daughter named Avesha, who was 3 years old. The family lived in the village of St. Michael, which was close by. A family friend set up a GoFundMe page to help pay for Myomick's funeral costs. Cynthia Hare wrote on the fundraising page, "She was kind and loved by everyone in her village of St. Michael and her second home in Wales. The rest of the week's classes at Kingikmuit School were cancelled, and counselors were flown to Wales to meet with students there." It's not clear why the polar bear attacked the mother and son, though Jeff York, the senior director of conservation at Polar Bear International, says that the species see people as food. In the US, a person was killed by a polar bear for the last time in 1990. The bear bit a man in a village north of Wales. Biologists said the animal was starving and desperate for food, as melting ice forces polar bears, the largest bear species, onto land where people live. People see them more often. The Endangered Species Act and the Marine Mammal Protection Act protect the bears, so it is illegal to hunt or hurt them unless it is for the safety of people. We're using this opportunity to send our condolences to the family of Summer Myomick. If you want to see more videos like this, make sure you like and subscribe to our channel.